Okay, so good morning class. The topic for this time is the gas turbine power plant. Okay. So this is an overview. So gas turbine power plant has relatively low costs and can be quickly put into commission. So ang ibig sabihin niyan, yung gas turbine power plant, madali lang siyang install. So unlike, let's say for example, a hydroelectric power plant, so it takes a long time before mo may put up, makapag-put up ng hydroelectric power plant. Okay? So consider mo dyan yung dam. No? Okay? So we know naman na yung dam is napakalaking structure niyan. Okay. Then this plant is also of smaller capacity and is mainly used for peak load service only. So pang ano lang siya, kumbaga in case of emergency, mga ganun pa, parang ano din sa generator, no? Yung ginagamit sa kapag walang kuryente, so parang ganun. Then the gas turbine power plants are very promising for regions where liquid or gaseous fuel is available in large quantities, so just like sa Middle East. Okay, so we know na dun marami ang gas, liquid and gaseous fuel, so malamang marami siguro ang ano dun, gas turbine power plant, no? Even yung ano, yung airplane, so yung cycle na ginagamit doon is gas turbine, no? Or yung tinatawag na Brayton cycle sa mga airplanes. Jets, parang ganun din sa jets, no? So introduction, an idealization often used in the study of open gas turbine power plants is that of an air standard analysis. So ano ba ang air standard analysis? In a standard analysis, two assumptions are always made. Number one, the working fluid is air, pure air. So inasyon natin na pure air, walang halo. There is no carbon dioxide. Okay. What else? Moisture or vapor, okay, which is actually meron, no? Which behave as an ideal gas. So, okay, so in real life, wala naman talagang ideal gas, but most of the gases, we assume that they behave as an ideal gas. So yan yung gagawin natin. Then number two, the temperature rise that would be brought about by combustion accomplished by heat transfer from an external source. Okay? So by an external source, wherein in most engines, the combustion is accomplished by an, actually that is internal, no? So sa loob ng engine nangyayari ang combustion, but here we assume na external, okay, yung source. Kumbaga hindi naghahalo yung fuel and yung air, okay? But in most engines, sabi ko nga, let's say for example, internal combustion engine, the combustion takes place inside the combustion chamber, or where the air and fuel mixes. So dito, na-assume natin na external. Okay? So we had this schematic diagram of a gas turbine power plant. Ito. So we had two. The first one is the open cycle. We call it open because as we can see, saan ba yung ano dito? Pen, disara, pen. Pen, disara yun. Dito pala yung pen. Yan. Oy. Ito na lang. Highlighter. Okay, oh. Laser na lang, okay? Ito. We call it open, no? open cycle. Ito, this is an open cycle. Okay. Since yung products or yung exhaust gases hindi na bumabalik dito, no? Okay. So we call it open, wherein kapag close, ito naman yung close cycle natin. Yung exhaust gases from the turbine, okay, so bumabalik dito kay compressor. Kumbaga pabalik-balik lang yung air, no? Kung ano yung air na pumasok dito, siya rin lang yung papasok ulit, no? So wherein dito is, we know naman of course na the products is, that is already toxic, oh, toxic or madumi na yan, may halong carbon dioxide, okay? And so on. So hindi na pwedeng ibalik dyan, okay? So that is open. And here in the schematic diagram, there are three basic components of a gas turbine power plant, that is a compressor. So it compresses the air into higher pressure, the combustion chamber where heat is added, and then the turbine, no? Okay, where power is generated. So yan. Then meron tayong ano dito, the shaft, okay, which in which the turbine drives the compressor, okay. So part of the power generated by the turbine is extracted by the compressor. So dito kumukuha ng power si compressor, okay. So same lang dito, only the difference is that, okay, meron tayong heat exchanger dito so that the gases from the turbine, okay, para bumalik sa dating temperature. So to reject heat, no? Okay. Wherein dito wala nang heat exchanger since the surrounding air, so siya na yung magsisilbing heat sink, no? Okay. Or parang yun na rin yung heat exchanger niya. Then we have the TS diagram. State 1, this is the compressor 1 to 2. We assume that the process in the compressor is constant entropy. So ganyan yung tsura. Then from 2 to 3, that is constant pressure, no? Constant pressure heat addition at the combustion chamber. And 3 to 4, that is in the turbine. We assume also that the process in the turbine is constant entropy. And fourth one, this is already the heat rejection, no? At the heat exchanger constant pressure process, okay, isobaric. TS diagram, okay, so constant entropy, constant pressure, constant entropy, and then constant pressure, okay? In case of the open cycle, no? So this, the TS diagram here is the TS diagram of the class 1, no? Okay, but in the open cycle, so this will be dotted line, no? Dotted line tong mga to, okay? Dotted lines. Ayan. So let's have an example, okay? So a gas turbine power plant operating under on an ideal Brayton cycle. So ito, this is the ideal Brayton cycle, okay? Ayan, ito yung ideal Brayton cycle natin. So ito yung processes kapag ideal cycle. Constant entropy, constant pressure, constant entropy, and then constant pressure. Okay? So, yan. Pressure ratio is 8. The gas temperature is 300 Kelvin at the compressor inlet and 1300 Kelvin at the turbine inlet. Utilizing air standard assumptions, okay? Determine A, the gas temperature at the exits of the compressor, and turbine B the backwork ratio, and C the thermal efficiency. Okay, so let's solve problem. Okay, so let us draw the schematic diagram. We have the compressor. Okay. And then the shaft connecting the compressor and the turbine. Okay, the combustion chamber where heat addition takes place, and then okay, so yeah, let's say state one, so this is 300 Kelvin, state two, state three, this is balikan lang natin yung slide, this is 1300 Kelvin, let's say state three. Then state 4, okay, then the power generated, ayan. Alright, so the pressure ratio is 8, no? RP, dito na lang natin ilagay, wherein RP, that is the pressure in the, in case of the Brayton cycle, that is equal to P2 over P1, or that is equal to P3 over P4. Okay, since P2 is equal to P3 and P1 is equal to P4. Okay, so that is equal to the Pmax, maximum pressure. Oh. Divided by the minimum pressure. Okay, so we are task to determine the temperature at state 2 and the temperature at state 4. What else? The backwork ratio and the thermal efficiency. Okay. So we also have to find the backwork ratio and then the thermal efficiency. Okay. So according to the problem, we have to use air standard assumptions. But before that, we will try to solve using cold air standard assumptions. So when you say cold air standard assumptions, no, we assume that the specific heat is constant throughout the cycle, no? Cp is equal to constant, no? Okay, so try muna natin to cold air standard assumptions, wherein actually the specific heat varies with temperature. It actually decreases. Now, habang tumataas yung temperature, the specific heat decreases. Okay, so we assume that the specific heat is constant. We will use the maybe 1.00. Okay, maybe 1.006, no? Okay, let's start. So how do we find the temperature at state 2? Okay, so since the process between state 2 is constant entropy, so going back to thermodynamics, okay, so balikan nyo yung thermodynamics ninyo, we have a formula to find for the temperature at state 2, ano na nga ba yun? That is equal to, if the process is isentropic, no? T2 over T1 is equal to P2 over P1 raised to K less 1 over K. That is when the process is S is equal to C, no? But if the process is not constant entropy, then palitan lang natin yung K ng N, no? If the process is not the process is polytropic, no? Okay, So T1 is given, P2 over P1 is also given, that is equal to 8. So T2 is equal to 300, and then 8 raised to 0.4 over 1.4. Okay, so we assume that the specific heat ratio is equal to 1.4, no? Okay, so the temperature at state 2 therefore is equal to, so ito na, makukuha na natin to. Calculator. That is equal to 543.43. That is in Kelvin. Take note that in this formula, the temperature and pressure must be absolute. No, ayan. Okay, next. The T2 is already determined, then T4. So going back to thermodynamics again, T3 over T4 is equal to P3 over P4 K less 1 over K. No? So nasa taas yung P3 natin. Okay? Yung 3. Nasa taas. Since the pressure at state 3 and the temperature at state 3 is higher compared to 4, no? Okay. So T4 is equal to T3, this is 1300, then divided by P3 over P4 is equal to 8. 8 raised to 0.4 over 1.4. Then T4, okay, as expected, yan ay mas mababa kay T3, no? That is 717.66 Kelvin. So ayan, nahanap na natin si T4, okay? Ano pa? Back work ratio. Okay? Back work ratio, that is equal to the, what's this? The work of the compressor over the work of the turbine, no? Kung gaano nga ba kalaki yung nakuha o napunta kay compressor, okay? Yan. So, but what is work of compressor? That is equal to mass flow rate, okay, of air multiplied by H2 less H1, okay? But since the CP is constant, then we can use work ng compressor over the mass is equal to CP T2 less T1, since enthalpy is equal to CP T, no? Okay, so yan. So per unit mass, since wala namang given na mass flow rate, so we assume that the mass is equal to 1, then CP 1.006, T2 is 543.43 minus T1 is 300. Then the work on compressor per unit mass. It's equal to 244.89, okay? Kilojoules per kilogram of air. 244.89 kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. Then how about the work ng turbine? So parang ganun din. Per unit mass, that is equal to 1.006 multiplied by T3, since yun yung mas mataas. 1,300 minus T4 is 717.66. Yan. Okay, so 1317.766. 585.83. Kilojoules per kilogram, no? Yan. So, the backwork ratio, therefore, is equal to... pwede naman in terms of temperature. Ito kasi magka-cancel din lang naman yan. Ito, 585 divided by 244.89. May yan ba yan? 244.89 divided by... That is 0.418, no? Or that is 41.80%. But in terms of temperature, pwede rin naman, no? Ano lang siya, magka-cancel naman tong CP. So, pwede rin in terms of temperature. But anyway, ito na lang gamitin natin. 585.83 divided by 244.89. Then, the backwork ratio is equal to, in terms, in percent, no? Multiply lang natin ng 100%, 41.80%. Okay, so that is the backwork ratio. Next, the thermal efficiency. Okay, but before that, so, iwan ko pala kayo, no? So, take note pala na yung area, okay? Yung area na nasa loob ng curves, ito, yung area na mga yan. So, actually, that is the work net, no? Okay, so, saglit nga. Meron ba tayong ano dito? Sige, slideshow ko na lang muna. Nasaan na yung laser? Hindi ko mahanap yung laser. Laser. Yun, pen. Ano eh? Pen, sorry, pen. Iba to, 10. Wala. Anyway, ito na lang. Magano na lang tayo. Create na lang ulit tayo ng panibago. Okay, sa PBNTS diagram, so yung area, this is PV diagram, this is P. Okay, yung area under the curve, nasa loob ng curve, okay, that is actually the work net, no? Okay, we're in sa TS diagram naman, parehas din lang. Na, yung area na ito is work net, no? So, and the area under this curve, no? This is the, okay? So, isipin ninyo na vertical, no? Yung mga drawings ko dyan. Ito yung QR, okay? Heat rejection. Then, the area under this curve naman, under this curve, no? Yung total, pagmula dyan hanggang dito, yun naman yung QA. Okay, that is QA. So, here, so since itong area naman na ito, under this curve, behind, I should say, behind the curve, nasa likuran ng curve na yan, that is work ng compressor, no? Okay, then behind this curve naman, behind this curve, kasama to, yun yung work ng turbine. Bakit behind? Since the process is steady, okay, or during the compression, is there is a mass, tawag dito, there is a mass that crosses the boundary, no? Okay? So, kaya steady flow yung kanyan. Okay, wherein kapag sa internal combustion engine, during compression kasi closes close yung mga valves, so there is no mass crossing the boundary, kaya yun ay non-flow naman nun. Okay, so ito ay steady flow, kaya behind, no? So kapag sa let's say assuming na ano kaya yung auto cycle, okay, auto cycle, pag auto cycle, para makuha yung work ng compression dito behind the curve ang ginagamit, kasi non-flow. Kapag steady, behind, okay, so yun. Anyway, ano lang naman yan. Review, no? Okay, so let's continue. Thermal efficiency. So, thermal efficiency. That is equal to work net over QA, no? Ayan. But there is also a formula na pwedeng gamitin. Direction na formula. Anyway, mamaya na lang yon. So this is equal to pwede ang work ng turbine less work ng compressor over QA, okay? Or pwede rin naman ito na ano, in terms QR1 less QR over QA, no? Ang daming pwedeng gamitin. In terms of pressure ratio naman, pwede nyo naman i-derive yung formula, derivable naman to, pwede naman i-derive. This 1 less 1 over RP to the K less 1 over K. Tama ba? If I am not mistaken, K less 1 over K. Kapag auto is wala ito eh, then RP ito. Oh, maybe tama yan. So anyway, check natin kung tama yung makukuha natin. So work net, yung ano na lang muna ang gamitin natin, work ng turbine, less work ng compressor. Wherein ang nakuha natin kanina dito na work ng ano 585.83 and then 244.89. 585.83 less 244.89. How about yung QA? Wala pang nakuha ang QA. So na lang natin dito, that is equal to CP 1.006 multiplied by T3, no? Minus T2. Ano ba ang T2? Ang T2 na ito natin kanina is543.83. Okay, so this is equal to 44.82%. Okay, kapag diretso na nating naka-percent ito, 44.82%. Okay. But in terms of RP, check natin kung tama, 1 less 1 over 8, 0.4 over 1.4. So check natin kung tama. Parehas kaya? 1 less 1 over 8, 0.4 over 1.4. 44.79, okay? Almost the same. So yan. So okay, so this is for example problem number 1. Okay, so tuloy natin mamaya yung next slides.